Hi guys, it's Andrea and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you my daily quarantine cleaning routine. Also, I'm going to be deep conditioning while I do this because why not multitask? Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Enjoy the video. So like always, I'm starting off with laundry. I'm doing a load of dark clothes. And you guys, I do realize that this shirt is a little bit short and later on in the video, you will notice that I did change it. And now I'm moving on to my son's bathroom. I chose to do this one first because I realized that this is the room that I hate to clean the most. So it really wasn't dirty. I'm just wiping everything down and the toilet is unused since the last time I cleaned it, which is why I didn't clean the inside. The only thing that really needed cleaning was the tub because that's the only thing he uses. A new product I decided to use was the Method Daily Shower Cleaner. And to my surprise, versus the Clorox, this one worked better as far as getting the dirt off the side of the tub. So I will definitely be using this again. So as you guys can see in this clip, this was when I decided to change my shirt. Maybe I should have done it a little bit earlier, like before scrubbing the tub, but yeah. The next room is my bedroom, and my bedroom really wasn't all that dirty. I just needed to straighten up my bed and organize my closet just a little bit better because I had been throwing things on the floor, which is not a very good habit of mine. I should really get rid of it. And also, for the first time cleaning my room ever, my dresser where my TV was, there was nothing on it. So which is why, that's why you guys don't see that clip. So now I'm moving on to my bathroom, and this is nowhere near a deep clean. This is more like a daily thing, and I like to get more in depth in my bathroom on weekly cleaning, so maybe like during the weekend time. And just like in my son's bathroom, I'm only going to wipe down the outside of the toilet to make sure that it's not dusty. So something that I realized that was on the Method shower cleaner was that it said a spray a day keeps the scrubbing away, which is why I'm only spraying down my shower. I'd really like to see if this makes a difference in cleaning my shower. So now I'm just moving on to sweeping and mopping, and then I'll be done with my bathroom. So now I'm moving on to my living room, and as you guys can see, my son threw all of his toys on the floor. I mean, I'm totally fine with it. It was pretty easy to pick up. It's not like they're really small Legos or something. But yeah, so that's all I'm doing is picking up all of his toys. I'm going to straighten out everything and make sure that it's in its proper place. Also, I'm trying to switch up the camera angle so that way every time I clean a room, it won't seem like you're seeing the same video over and over and over again. So let me know if these camera angles are working for you guys or if you prefer the ones that I usually use. Now I'm using the same 7th generation wood cleaner to clean my coffee table. However, I know that you guys see the creases in my coffee table and those are filled with little crumbs of everything. So I'm trying to find a method of getting those crumbs out without damaging the wood. So if you guys have a tip for that, please let me know in the comments. Also, I'm only showing you guys a small portion of me sweeping and mopping my living room floor, but do keep in mind that I did sweep and mop the rest of it. I just knew that it wouldn't be in frame, so I didn't include it. My dining table really didn't need anything done to it. I just ended up taking the things off of the table. So now I'm switching out my load of dark clothes and I'm gonna load up a load of towels. Now I'm collecting all of my clothes because I don't like to stop and fold and then continue cleaning. So I'm just gonna fold everything towards the end of the video. So y'all are gonna see that I forgot to start the dryer. And I didn't notice this until my towels finished in the washer. So I ended up having to leave them in the washer and then turn on the dryer and wait an additional hour just to switch them out. Now moving on to the kitchen, and I would like to point out that I did add baby sunscreen to the countertop where I keep my items that I normally grab on my way out the door because it is now the sunny season and I just have to have sunscreen for my baby. As you guys can see here, he did wake up from his nap when I was cleaning this portion of the kitchen, so be expecting to see my little shadow crawling after me. I've been there, but I have to stay afloat. It's nice, be a person you. Now I'm moving on to loading up the dishwasher and I'm going to be washing his bottles. Where's the life I? Where's my shy head? Is this called living? I don't know. Where's the life I? Where's my shy head? Is this called living? I don't know. I don't wanna grow. Just let myself. Now you guys are going to see here that he took the child safety lock off of the floor and he put it in the dishwasher. Now I didn't notice until after I turned the dishwasher on, and you guys are going to see that part later on. Look behind me. So here I am searching for the child safety lock, and then I realized that he put it in the dishwasher. And luckily, the dishwasher hadn't started completely, so I didn't have to burn myself with hot water just to get it out. I did want to take this time to see if you guys noticed that I did slow down this video at least to half of the speed that I normally upload them at. I got a couple of requests to slow it down a little bit, so this is what I did. And I do plan on making a video in the future that will be much, much longer than what I normally upload, but I just wanted to see if you guys like this speed that I'm going at right now. So now I'm just finishing off my last countertop, and then I'm going to move over to cleaning my stove. Now guys, my stove really wasn't that bad. I didn't even have to break out the Comet this time. I just had to put a little bit of elbow into cleaning it. And y'all, don't come for me about my rusty little teapot, okay? It still works and I love this teapot. And to finish off the kitchen, I'm just going to sweep and mop and take out the garbage, and then I'll be done. And just a little friendly reminder to you guys, don't forget to recycle. And the last room that I will be doing will be my son's room. Now his room doesn't really get messy to the point where I need to deep clean, so this is mostly what I do all the time. It's just me picking up things off of the floor and clearing off his dresser where most of the clutter ends up being. So like I said in my previous videos, this rug is very beautiful, but it does shed. So that's the only reason why I'm vacuuming, is because there's little blue specks everywhere. You guys just can't see them. So does anybody else save laundry for last, just as a relaxing moment after cleaning your whole house? I feel like it's kind of like a cool down after you've done a really vigorous workout. So these two baskets that I'm bringing in are a new linen closet system that I've adapted. So instead of having the towels stacked up and looking really unneat, I roll them up into the baskets, and that way it's just two baskets full of towels and it doesn't look as cluttered as if you would stack them. By the way, these baskets are from Dollar Tree, so if you need a new system for your linen closet, go ahead and pick yourself up some. So the very last thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to put away our clothes and then I will be completely done. So I really hope that you guys enjoyed the video. I hope that you enjoyed the fact that I did slow it down for you guys. And if you guys did not like that, just go ahead and let me know in the comments and I will gladly fix it for the next video. But like always, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!